Hello everybody, this is Mr. Fae, and here we have Via! So, Loot Assassin! Yeah! So, this is a new build in Titan Quest Anniversary Edition plus Ragnarok plus Atlantis. And here we have it. This is the Absolute Assassin I was talking about in the past few weeks. It is a very, very, very fresh and very new build, of course. I have started this character from level 65 because I'm using now my new method of creating high level characters that can play instantly. They can start actually instantly in legendary difficulty and they don't have to go and play normal and epic, because this way we save time and we can play even more builds in the game and make even more builds. And this is it. Here we are. My character is now level 72. I started playing on Legendary. I am here in the Hades Act, Stygian March of Hades Act. And, well, we can see some things here. You can see actually some things here, some numbers, some crazy numbers, and some other crazy things down here. Well, let's take things from the beginning. What is the idea of this build? Actually, you can see the name of the build. The name of the build is not the Absolute Assassin. Why I call this build Absolute Assassin? Because it is an assassin class, but absolute because of how this build performs. And also how well this build is reminiscent of assassins in general, in real life. I mean, an assassin does not use a bow, an assassin uses daggers, and an assassin assassinates enemies super very fast because this is how he deals his, he finishes his job, and things like that. So, this build does exactly that. It uses daggers, it kills enemies super very fast, and very efficient, in a very efficient way, and this is why I call it the Absolute Assassin. But the true name of the build is the Stinger. The Stinger. Why the Stinger? Because 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Here. Here. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. The Stinger. This is the build. The Stinger build. The actual name of the build. I wanted to make a build where I would be utilizing many lethal strikes. How do I have 3 here? And also you will ask, how do I have 2 warwits here? Okay, maybe some of you will think that I'm cheating. I'm not cheating, because the game allows you, if you know how to do it, to have 3 lethal strikes and 2 warwits. Actually, you can have 3 warwits, but not on this build, because you can get 1 warwit from a spear. I think it is the weapon, the legendary spear Aristrath, which is the spear of God of War, that comes with the skill Warwind. And you can combine that spear with these 2 skills that come from other sources and have 3 warwits. Actually, I have made such a build. It is my God of War build, God of War version 2. And if you want, you can check that build in the channel. It is an old build, but a nice build. Nothing special, but a nice build. And here we are now, having to utilize 3 lethal strikes. Which is awesome, I like this skill very much. And it feels awesome killing enemies with this one, stinging enemies. The Stinger it is. So, let's go to the masteries and skills and whatnot. I'm playing with Warfare and Rogue, of course this gives the assassin class. I'm using dual wield because I want to hold 2 weapons, dual wielding daggers. And the Hue one, this one for now at least, which is a very nice skill, which when it hits enemies it deals a huge amount of damage. Of course we have the weapon training because we use daggers. Daggers actually are swords, they belong to the sword type, so we get these offensive abilities and attack speeds. I have this skill here, Battle Rage, and this one here, and just a point here. This help deal more damage when they trigger, so I have them here because I can. I have this one maxed out. I play of course with Battle Standard and the Triumph. Of course this one reduces physical damage of enemies. This one increases our it gives us skills, plus one to all skills, and also it provides more physical damage to our attacks and offensive ability, which is awesome. Which means even more frequent critical hits. Here we have the onslaught, of course, we have it down here, and with the addons maxed out. These skills are maxed out currently. I get my first Warwind from this one, the skill at the addon. The Warwind is very nice because it also allows us to move very fast many times in the map. And it makes the build much more efficient and of course faster and more satisfying to play with. And here we have the Warhorn with Doomhorn. These are the skills I'm using right now with, from Warfare Mastery. Now, Rogue Mastery, what do we have here? Of course, we have Lethal Strike. Why? Because this is the build. This is a Lethal Strike build. This is why we call it the Stinger. And it feels awesome. It feels truly awesome killing enemies with this attack here. We can see the buffs. Of course, this is totally maxed out. It has reached its ultimate level, which is level 16 out of 12. And the same applies here as well. Well, you will ask now, are you really dealing any bleeding damage? No. Are you dealing poison damage? Yes. I get some poison damage from this skill here. Of course, in the future, the plan is to, if possible, to max out these skills here. But this is not a poison build, it is not a damage over time build. I'm just using this one to give me a little bit more damage output and to confuse enemies with this one and whatnot. I'm also using this one for the 3 seconds of stun. You hit enemies with this one, if you do not kill them and they are not very big bosses, maybe you can stun them. Hero enemies, for example, you can stun them, and it helps with your survivability because if you stun your enemies, they do not attack you. Simple as that. Here we have the Blade Honing. You know, this gives you more piercing damage and also it increases the pierce ratio of your items, like this one for example. This one already has 50% pierce ratio, a plus 88%. Yeah, you can see that this one now we convert around 90% of the base damage of the dagger from physical to pierce because of this combination of this pierce ratio and this one here, the plus 88% decrease pierce ratio. And on top of the conversion, we get also the 31% damage. So, we can see the numbers here, average damage and the DPS. If I click this one, almost double. Just by clicking this one. Okay, if I click this one as well, nothing insignificant because it is not really maxed out this one. But it doesn't matter. I mean, if we click this one, it goes even higher. And if we start hitting enemies with onslaught, which increases even further our physical damage, you can see that this one goes even higher and we totally destroy enemies with this build. We truly assassinate enemies, even undead enemies. You know, undead enemies come, especially ghosts, they come with very high pierced physical damage resistances, especially ghosts, and also poison resistances, poison absorption, a very high one, undead, and the ghosts, they come with poison immunities, the ghosts undead, not all of the undead. You can apply poison and deal poison damage to skeletons undead, but not very much, not a big amount. Unless you play with something like the Defiler build, which I made a long time ago, which is a poison damage build, and it destroys also skeleton and dead enemies with poison damage. Anyway, I'm using of course the disarm traps because of the stats that it provides, very useful stats, and as I said before, I use a little bit of this one, of this one, of this one, and this one which confuses enemies, and this is the build. This is my status of my 2 skill trees for now, so far. Of course, my character is level 72. To reach level 85, which is the level cap, it means you will gain 13 more levels. 13 more levels is how many? 39 more skill points, because it is 3 skill points per level up. So yeah, it is 39. With 39 more skill points, I guess I can at least max out this one and maybe this one here. Yeah, something like that. We will see. I don't know. Of course, I could start using the Blade Barrier as well, but this build, you know, Blade Barrier with an Assassin, the theme doesn't really fit very well, because Assassin is supposed to be something like a ninja, to attack from the shadows, from behind, and attack super very fast and kill, assassinate enemies very very fast, you know. With Blade Barrier, you kill enemies super very fast. For example, take a look at my controversial Brigand build, and you will see how powerful this build, this skill can be. But yeah, it doesn't fit the theme of Assassin very well, in my opinion, so I'm not using this one. How do we have all of the skills down here? We have nothing in my secondary hotbar key, hotbar of keys, hotkey bar, whatever. And here we have these skills. How? Well, we get this one. We get it from here. But if you go to play with three times Lethal Strike, you have to be using this item. Dagger of Dawn. The Dagger of Dawn is a legendary item which is super duper powerful, and it is more powerful actually than Giant's Tooth. Now, having said that, I hope the developers will not nerf this item as well, because they have already nerfed Giant's Tooth. Anyway, this is a super powerful item. You can see the stats of this item right now. We get double physical damage buffs and whatnot, because this is an upgraded item in you know, the upgrade feature of legendary difficulty of the campaign. We get a quest which allows us to upgrade one item. This is an upgraded one. This was given away to the community built by Albadi, I think. And we have one more here. These are not duplicates, these are different instances. This one was also given by Albadi. We have two upgraded items in Legendary, and both came with this, you know, physical damage, more physical damage, and more physical damage, and whatnot. This is super powerful. Dagger of Dawn. Super powerful. And I'm using, you can see that this item grants the skill Lethal Strike, which is this one. Where? Wait. Yeah, this one. Of course, this Lethal Strike is not as powerful as the Lethal Strike of the Mastery, because in the Mastery you can max out the levels of the skill and have it up to level 16, and have it get so many buffs, 600% physical and 450 pierce. From the items, the skills are not as powerful as from the Masteries when we get on item skills that belong also to Masteries. But it doesn't really matter. This one is very powerful. This one is very powerful. One, this one comes from this one, and this one comes from this one. So, sometimes we hit enemies with this one, then we hit other enemies with this one, and then we hit enemies with this one. Of course, when we attack enemies, we cannot keep attacking as I'm attacking right now on the air. Why? Because all of these skills have a cooldown. They have a cooldown. And the cooldown is not very small. It is not a big one, but it is not very small, which means it will not allow you to keep attacking like this your enemies. But right now I can attack, the cooldown is not working because I'm not hitting any enemies. If I hit enemies, you will see the cooldown starts working. But anyway, the point is that this combination is super powerful. These skills are very powerful, even at these buffs only, 275 physical and 255 pierce. Very very powerful combination. And of course, when you have this average damage at the DPS, I mean, this is crazy, and without even having this one active. This is crazy. These are not the biggest numbers you will ever see in Titan Quest. There are even higher numbers that you can see, but it doesn't matter, because what matters here is for the build to kill enemies as fast as possible, and this one kills enemies super fast, assassinates enemies. So, we have here Warfare. This one We get one warfare from this one. 8 targets maximum, it is this one. And the second warfare comes from this item, Myrmidon's Pendant. It grants the skill Warweed. We get this Warweed from this one, and this Warweed from Warfare Master. And if we were playing, for example, with the Spear of God of War Aris Wrath, and had it here, then we would have one more Warweed. Of course, I'm not going to do that with this bit, because this bit is about daggers, not spears. It is about assassin, not a god. So, this is the build. My other items are the Talisman of the Jade Emperor because of the recharge time reduction and the rest of the stats. The Trunks of Mogon, mostly because of the resistances that it provides. I'm using, of course, this one because of the resistances and Warweed, and also the 33% physical damage. This is also an upgraded Myrmidon's Pendant. I don't remember what the upgrades were, but anyway, it is an upgraded one. I'm using the Gauntlets of the Necrolord, super powerful item in general in the game, for the resistances that it provides, the attack damage cover to health, and the plus one to all skills of course, dodge attacks, attacking speed and whatnot. By the way, attack speed 200% is maxed out when you use when you dual wield items. This is the highest you can get. And I'm using the Apollo's Wheel here with a very nice number of pierce damage buff, and of course because of the resistances. The same applies to this one, 106% pierce damage and resistances. I have here this one, Helm of Vahal, super great item. This comes with a prefix and a suffix. It is a mastery frequent. The suffix is the Glade one, and it provides plus 22% pierce damage. Super awesome, and also the resistances I get are super awesome, vitality, pierce, and more armor for this item only, and chance to avoid projectiles and whatnot. And of course I used this legendary Yeti Fuhr charm on this one, because I needed the cold resistance. Now I have cold resistance maxed out because of this charm here, which is awesome. And here, finally, we have the Skyronian armor. This is also a great item, plus 3 to all skills rogue mastery. I decided to go with this stew of Eldimir, whatever, with the energy regeneration and strength buffs, because you know this build requires lots of strength, enough strength to be able to equip this item, and this item, and maybe this item as well, you know. We need strength. And this combination here of this strength from this relic is awesome. It helps. But I think I can take it off right now. I don't really need this incarnation of the stew here. And if I take it off, maybe I can enchant this item with another relic or charm, which would give me lightning resistance and bleeding resistance. If I do that, my resistances will be perfect. This one is almost perfect, 78 out of 80%, it is actually perfect. 2% is not really something important, but these ones are not perfect. They are good, but not perfect. So, in the future, I will keep an eye out, and I will try to take this off, not the item itself, only the relic from this item, and replace it with another component, which would give me the combination of lightning resistance and bleeding, if I can find something like that. I probably can, but I'm just saying if. Attributes. I have dexterity, the white numbers, 346, strength, 346, and health, 780. Why the white numbers? Because in the white numbers, actually, you can see how many, and you can calculate how many points you have spent on each one of the attributes. When you start a character and you haven't applied any attribute points on your character, then you will see that your character's white numbers of health and energy are 300. You can see here energy 300. And strength, intelligence and dexterity is 50. Intelligence 50. So, this means that I haven't applied any attribute points on intelligence, which is 50 now, and energy, which is 300. So, by taking a look here, for example, strength, you have 346 white number. It starts from 50 when you start playing a new character. So, you have to do the calculation and see how many points you have spent on strength, dexterity and whatnot. Anyway, this right now doesn't really matter. What matters is that I put points on strength because I needed strength, you know, to be able to equip items. I invested many points. You can do the calculation yourselves. I spent many points on dexterity because we need dexterity a good amount to be able to equip items like this one. And also, of course, we need dexterity for the offensive and defensive abilities, which is not super high, at least the offensive one. But you know, this build right now deals so much damage that I don't even need to increase my offensive ability even further to be able to be dealing even more frequently critical hits. I don't need to do that, because even if I don't deal critical hits, many times I hit my enemies with numbers like 10,000, 20,000 damage, non-critical damage. And these numbers destroy, they kill instantly many enemies. Sometimes maybe even hero enemies, or not, I don't remember. Anyway, it doesn't matter. What matters is that this build is super duper powerful and also awesome. So, how do I spend health points, attribute points? Right now, after I level up, I spend points on health. Why? Because my damage output is so high that I don't even need to spend any more points on dexterity and strength to increase my physical and pierce damages. So what do? I spend points now on health to increase my survivability. And if I manage in the future to max out these two skills, yeah, we are talking about a super awesome build then. By the way, let me go back to a town. Unless I have it with me. I don't have it with me. Let me go back to Rhodes. Here, I want to show you something. Wait, where is it? Ah, it is not here. It is here. This one. Yeah. Storm Raven Sword. If you don't have the Dagger of Dawn, if you haven't found the Dagger of Dawn, this is the best next thing for this build. This item is a Mastery Frequent Sword, and it comes with the skill Lethal Strike. So, even if you don't have Dagger of Dawn, you can farm twice this one. You farm it in Ragnarok Act, it drops from enemies like Enhirias and whatnot sometimes. It is a rare item actually, at least in my case, but it can drop there. Of course, since it is a Mastery Frequent, it can also come with prefixes like Veterans, for example, and great suffixes as well, if you are lucky enough, and you get the Lethal Strike, and it is very powerful. I mean, take a look, if I take one off, of course, the damage goes down in a huge way, but still, this one is very powerful, still, it is very, very powerful. And it can, of course, you can see here, we cannot see it here because I have to restore it. This one comes now from this one. Yeah, you can use this one. Of course, if you start using this sword twice, you will not be dealing as much damage as you deal with this one and this one, especially equipped together. Not so much damage, but wait. I have to activate this one. Yeah, here we are now. With this one active and this one active, we have 4, 5, 8, 2, and 7, 8. Very, very powerful. This one is still very powerful, but this one, of course, it is the absolute item for this absolute assassin build. So, whenever you see this item falling on the ground, especially legendary difficulty, and having many stats, prefixes, and suffixes, maybe you want to save the item in your collection because it is a super duper awesome item. And I have it here. I hope I can find a second one, actually many more copies of this item in the future, with even better affixes, especially veterans prefix. Yeah, why not? And maybe equip it here and have fun also with a couple of these items as well on this build. Or maybe another build. I don't think I will make another build with, you know, too many lethal strikes, but anyway, it doesn't really matter. So, everybody, this is the build. Let's go and kill something now. Here we are. We have all of our skills active. Let's go this way. Where are my enemies? Here. Of course, these crabs, they have very good pierce resistances. So, you know, enemies that have very, very good pierce resistances will not get killed so fast. But still, we will destroy them. Let's do this move. You saw this one died by one hit. Chuck, down he goes. This one is still alive. But of course, yeah, let's not forget that this build requires also the usage of many energy potions. Because we don't have enough energy. And if you start using all the time the skills, yeah, you waste your energy. Let's use this one. Did you see that? This minor boss, one hit from this one, killed it. One hit from this one, killed it. And bone pile. I want to fight some troglodytes. Let's go this way. Of course, these frogs are easy to kill, nothing special. I'm showing you now the Warweed, the movement that we get from Warweed, which is awesome. It helps very much running faster in the maps, and also killing many enemies many times together at one hit. Let's go down there. Zoop! Away they go. Of course, you can use this stunning effect, the Warhorn, to stun your enemies if you want. Zoop! Down he goes. And we can see the, you know, the playstyle of this build is very simple. You attack with your main attacks. You hit enemies with these three skills, and you move faster by hitting enemies with these ones. Simple as that. And if you fight any, you know, challenging battles, then you use your battle standard and you kill enemies. Oops, there is one alive. Why? We can see how fast our energy regenerates as well, which is awesome. And this happens, you know, because of that component on this item, the Stew of Eldimir. Soup, down you go. Yeah, now these enemies were going to kill me. You know, I have gotten killed 5 times so far. But okay, you know, sometimes I'm reckless. I don't pay attention to what is going on everywhere on the map. And I get killed. But it doesn't matter, I'm not trying to play hardcore, I don't care about hardcore here. With this character. This one is still alive. Crabs have a very good pierce resistances. You cannot kill them very fast. Oops! This one is still alive. Down you go. You see, you saw that was not a critical hit. Oh! Aha! Okay. Yeah, so. This is the gameplay, guys. It is very simple and very effective, I would say. We kill enemies very fast, especially when they are not crabs and they don't have so good pierce resistances. But even when they are crabs, we can kill them very, very fast. It is very simple, you know, in maybe if you got me in a future live stream, I can live stream this build a little bit, and of course play multiplayer in the future, you know, in Saturdays with this one. It is an awesome build, I totally love it. It is my absolute assassin build, which truly feels like an assassin. I mean, the playstyle feels like an assassin. I'm not using any magic tricks, I'm not using any bows and shields and spears, I'm using only daggers, and I have the poison damage here, which fits the theme of assassin, and I run very fast to my enemies, hit them, kill them, apply poison a little bit and kill them. Of course, poison is not good enough to kill enemies before my daggers kill enemies, but this is the job of an assassin. Assassinate your enemies. Everybody, thanks for watching this video. Subscribe if you haven't done so yet, if you like what you see, of course. And I will see you very soon with much more content of Titan Quest, Wilson, and ActionRPG Sundays as well. So, I'll be back very soon. Bye-bye.